right, and welcome back to another segment of Raul's World of Synths. This time around, we're going to be looking at a further exploration of the A188-2 tapped BBD module, but we're going to be looking at something called the Karplus Strong Patch. This patch, if you're interested in it, can actually be found on Doepfer website on the A188-1 page, which is the little brother of this module here. But I'm going to sort of adapt it to this module in this segment. So before we go into that and hear what that sounds like, let's talk a little bit about what exactly Karplus Strong indicates to you. So when you hear Karplus Strong, it's referring to a type of synthesis whereby you can actually create synthesized strings or reeds or also brass instruments. And it's supposed to make them sound more true to life. It's also sometimes used with the words physical modeling. So you might hear those kind of used interchangeably or one referring to the other. So that's actually what we're talking about, is creating string sounds or reed sounds, or brass as well. I'm going to be doing actually a patch that sort of creates a little bit of reed and a little bit of strings. But to do that, we're going to have to do a little bit of setup, and that's why we have these modules here in front of us. So the way it works is a short noise burst is actually going to be going into a feedback line, and a delay line more specifically, and that is going to help us create a string sound. And so I'm not going to go into too many details about some of these modules. I have done some kind of detailed explanations on the A140 and the A131, so if you're unfamiliar with those, you might want to go check those out. I haven't done one yet on the A117. Maybe coming up in the future sometime I'll do that. But for now, we'll just know that we're going to use this as our noise source. So before we jump in and kind of use it, let's hear what that actually is going to sound like. So I'm just going to patch this straight in to my A188-2 so we can hear what that sounds like. So kind of a digital noise source. You get the idea. Basically noise. So we're going to use that, but a short burst of it in order to create a string sound. Now, in order to do that, we're going to have to do a little bit of setup. So I'm going to take my noise out for my A117, and I'm going to patch it into my VCA right here, my A131. And then I'm going to take the audio out of my VCA, and I'm going to patch it into the audio in of my BBD. Now, I'm not going to hear anything quite yet, because my gain, as you can see on the A131, is turned all the way down, so nothing is happening yet there. My envelope is actually going to be shaping my VCA, so I need to patch my output of my A140, I'm sorry, over to my gain of my A131, and that is the basic setup. Now I just have two other things that I have to set up. I need to trigger my envelope, and I also need to send a CV over to my 188-2. So for that, I'm going to use different color cables. One of them is actually going to be triggering a gate, and they're going to be coming up from the bottom, just for practicality's sake. So this one is actually going to be bringing in my gates. So I'm going to route this over to my A140. There we go. And you can see right there, my envelope is now being triggered. You may be able to hear just ever so slightly a click coming in, and that is my white noise coming in a very short burst. So now what I need to do is I need to patch in my notes coming from my sequencer out here, and incidentally that's where the gate signal is coming from as well. It's being sent from a sequencer, and so I'm going to patch that right into CV2. So there, it's patched. We don't hear anything yet for two reasons. One, we're not really utilizing too much of the BBD quite yet. Let me bring all of these back to Unity or Zero. There we go. And I haven't brought this up yet. So I need to choose a BBD flavor that I'd like to use for this. So for Karplus Strong Synthesis, they usually recommend the lower stages, but it can be sort of utilized in the upper stages as well. So let's start out with a 396, and we'll bring that up a little bit. And then I'm going to bring my mix up a little bit, and we should start to hear kind of a little plucky kind of sound. There we go. So there we go. We got a little bit of a plucky kind of string sound going on there. So go ahead and get that in your ears a little bit. And so that is the basic patch that we're going to start out with to synthesize this. I did do a little bit of setup just so that way we could get at a good jumping off point. My delay clock is right there at about 6, and I have a positive component of my control voltage coming in. Which is actually just actually triggering the pitch of this, which is why you hear it pitched, playing little notes right there. Now, one of the things I discovered by delving into this patch here is that the feedback, for the most part, is what's key in this patch, and I'm going to demonstrate that here shortly. So, right now I have it set about there. But watch what happens if I bring it up a little bit. It becomes a much more sustained tone. There we go. So there, it almost doesn't sound quite like a plucked string anymore. It sounds a little bit more like a sustained, maybe like a bass guitar or something like that. And if I go a little bit too far on my feedback, it sounds a little more full. If I bring that back down, I can get more of a plucky kind of sound, more like you'd expect from maybe guitar, sitar kind of thing. Now, you can kind of adjust also the amount of which your string sounds sort of muted as well by adjusting the rate of the noise going into the delay line over here. So I'm going to go ahead and demonstrate that. I'm going to bring that up a little bit. And right about there, you should hear it slightly more muted. And we'll bring it up a little farther. So that's all the way at the maximum rate of digital noise. Almost like it's fading away. So if I bring it all the way back down, we should hear a little more plucky sound. And then this is with the 396 variety going on right now. Okay, so let's bring this back to zero. So we should have about pretty close to silence. Now let's try a different variety. Let's jump all the way to the 1194, bring that up a little. Still got a little bit of a plucky sound. There we go, I kind of like that. Feedback a little bit. So you can kind of adjust this to taste to wherever you feel like you like the pluckiness or this kind of string sound that you are patching. And now you may be wondering what happens if you adjust the delay clock. So let me do that just a little bit just so you can kind of see what kind of effect it will have on it. So that almost sounds like a, I don't know, like a straw or maybe like a very muted kind of percussion, kind of maybe marimba or xylophone kind of sound. And then maybe I could adjust my feedback. So there's tons and tons of possibilities here from just very subtle changes in your feedback and your delay setting. Now, one slight variation of this patch, in order to create sort of a reed type sound, is going to be found in your envelope generator here. That's going to be found right in the sustain, or that's where I found it, according to the settings that I have here. So if I bring up the sustain, we should hear something that sounds a little bit like a reed. Or almost like a pan flute. That's right there in the sustain. Now at a certain point you might lose that the higher you go in the sustain. Eventually you get a lot of the noise just coming all the way through. But you just kind of adjust it until your ear tells you that, you know, it sounds like what you think it should sound like. Like to me, I kind of like the pluckiness of it there. Now you can increase or decrease the pluckiness as well by adjusting the attack of your envelope. So if I bring that up a little bit, I'm going to make it a little less plucky. And all the way at the top, I kind of lose my pluckiness altogether. But all the way down at the bottom, and there I have my pluckiness back. So that's your basic Karplus Strong patch, as seen on the Doepfer website, but adapted for the A188-2. And that is, again, with the 1194 variety. So let's bring this down a little bit. Now for this last little attempt at this patch, let's actually go in and we'll add a few different flavors of this before moving on to the next segment. So I'm going to bring up maybe the 3328 a little bit. Now we have a nice little kind of plucky response happening right there. I'm going to bring my sustain down just a little bit right there. Okay, and then I'm going to bring my 2790 actually in the negative direction, just to experiment, and then let's bring the 1726 up a little. And then let's bring up maybe the 1194 in the negative component. Maybe the 662 as well. There we go. And okay, I'm kind of liking that. Let's bring up the feedback just a little bit. I think I've kind of lost my pluckiness a little bit. Got it back a little bit. Let's go just right into a reed then. And then if I wanted to, I could bring back a little bit of my original, which is basically just my little short burst of noise. But I just adjust it to taste. Karplus Strong Patch, adapted for the A188-2.